गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल. ज्ञानसागराच्या भेटीसाठी चला प्रवाही होऊया कथा सरिता या उपक्रमामध्ये. रोजे कथा ऐकूया. रिजनल अकॅडमिक अथॉरिटी मुंबई वेलकम्स यू ऑल इन कथा सरिता प्रोग्राम. टुडेज डेट इज 21 नोव्हेंबर 2021, बट ॲज वी ऑल नो दॅट एव्हरी डे इज अ स्पेशल डे, सो देर आर सम टुडेज डे स्पेशल टू. सो टुडेज डे स्पेशल इज टुडे इज वर्ल्ड टेलिव्हिजन डे अँड World Day of Remembrance of Road Traffic Victims. So, myself Sarish Pawar is going to tell you a wonderful story, Cyclone. Dorothy lived in the midst of the great Kansas prairies with Uncle Henry and Aunt Em, who was a farmer's wife. Their house was small for a lumber to build. It had to be carried by wagon many miles. There were four walls, a floor, and a roof, which made one room. And this room contained a rusty-looking cooking stove, a cupboard for the dishes, a table, 3-4 chairs, and the beds. Uncle Henry and Aunt Em had a big bed in one corner, and Dorothy had a little bed in another corner. There were no upstairs at all, and no cellar, except a small hole dug in ground, called a cyclone cellar, where the family could go in case of any one of those great whirlwinds arose. When Dorothy stood in the doorway and looked around, she could see nothing but the great gray prairie on every side. Not a tree, not a house broke the edge of the broad sweep of the flat country that reached to the edge of the sky in all directions. The sun had baked the bowed land into a gray mass with little cracks running through it. Even the grass was not green. Once the house was painted, but the sun blistered the house, blistered paints, and the rains washed away. And now the house is dull and as gray as everything else. When Aunt Em came there to live, she was a young, pretty wife. The sun and the wind has changed her too. They had taken the sparkle from her eyes and left them a sober gray. They had taken the red from her cheeks and lips, and they were gray also. Uncle Henry never laughed. He worked hard from day to night and did not know what joy was. He was gray also. It was Toto that made Dorothy and laughed and saved from growing gray as her other surroundings. Toto was not gray. He was a black little dog with long and silky hair and small black eyes that twinkled merrily on either side of his funny wee nose. Today, however, Dorothy and Toto were not playing. Uncle Henry sat upon the doorstep, looked anxiously at the sky, which was even grayer than usual. Dorothy stood in the door with Toto in her arms and looked at the sky too. Aunt Em was washing the dishes. Suddenly, Uncle Henry stood up. "There's a cyclone coming, Em," he called to his wife. "I'll go look after the livestock." He ran towards the sheds where the cows and horses were kept. Aunt Em dropped her work and said, "Quick, Dorothy, quick!" She screamed, "Run for the cellar!" Toto jumped out of the Dorothy's arms and hid under the bed. Dorothy started to get him. Aunt Em climbed down the ladder into the small dark hole. When she was halfway across, there came a great shriek from the wind, and the house shook up so hard that she lost her footing and sat down upon the floor. A strange thing happened. The house whirled around 2 or 3 times and rose slowly up the air. Dorothy felt as if she were in going balloon. The north and south winds met where the house was stood and made it exact the center of the cyclone. In the middle of cyclone, the air is generally still, but the great pressure of the wind on every side rose the house very up. It was very dark and the wind howled horribly around her, but Dorothy found that she was riding quite easily after the few first whirls around. And no other time, when her house tipped badly, she felt as if she were being rocked gently like a baby in a cradle. Toto did not like it. He ran about the room, now here and now there, barking loudly.
But Dorothy sat quiet on the floor and waited to see what would happen. Once Toto got too near to the trap door and fell down. Girl at first thought that she lost Toto, but for her surprise, she saw someone's ear. It was nothing else, but it was Toto's ears. The pressure by the downwind caught the Toto up so that he could not fall. She crept him to the hole, caught Toto by the ear and dragged him into the room again. Afterward, closing the trapdoor so no more accidents would happen. After hour passed away and slowly Dorothy got over her fright, but she felt quite lonely and wind shrieked so loudly all about her that she nearly dashed into pieces when the house fell again. As the hours passed and nothing terrible happened, she stopped worrying and resolved to wait calmly and see what future would bring. At last, she crawled over a swaying floor to her bed and laid down upon it. Toto followed her and laid down beside her. In spite of swaying of the house and billowing of the wind, Dorothy soon closed her eyes and fell fast asleep.
So friends, hope you like today's story. If you like the story, press the like button, share this story with your friends and families. Also, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get notification of such interesting stories. So, thank you for watching.